you know, and I don't know if you're aware of this, and I have
no idea. Yes, you weren't opposed to it? Certainly would pass.
No, I know prior to the vote, if there were problems with the 30 deaths that you have, 60, before the debate started?
We were pretty comfortable that we were right on the number. But obviously, you know, a lot of people jumped off it after it didn't get up there.
So a lot of people drop off as sure. What was going on.
Everybody's just sure. It got to, I don't know what it got to, 53 before.
Yeah.
52, okay. And then ended up at 48 pretty quickly.
Yeah. So it's, I mean, you don't plan to bring this back?
I put it on postponed consideration because they asked me to do that, and a lot of people put a lot of work into this. So hopefully, we'll see if anybody has a change of heart. The legislative session goes to November. But, you know, we had some pretty hard commitments from some people. And it's evident that they didn't stick by those commitments.
Did you lose more Republican support or Democrat support?
I think it was pretty equal. It was probably if there was any, there's probably more Republicans voted for it than
Democrats. Do you think that there was a play on the speaker's part, making having the Republicans go on the record on a vote and then going back?
No, the speaker wanted to pass this bill. He was very helpful. Everyone I asked him to talk to, he talked to people that did not vote for it, that had committed to him or I, that they didn't vote for it. Well, that's the process, and sometimes it happens.
Back to the content of the bill, was there anything in there that, beyond taking the Illinois standardized test, that would have measured the performance of these students once they were transferred to
Princeton? No, the ISAT test was really the only way that we could regulate the performance of it. Obviously, there's they kept the identification.
Well, thank you, sir. You have a
is issued to them through CPS and ISBE, that would track them throughout their time at the private school, so that their access to their grades and to their school as well as attendance and academics.
You get the juxtaposition of Duncan on the one hand and Turner on the other hand, and you know, very similar districts, and just two completely different opinions. You know, what can be done in the whole education debate to kind of bridge those two gaps?
Well, you know, if you look at the opponents of the bill and the arguments that people took up, some of them were very passionate. They believe it, and they believe in public education, as do I, and as do I think Representative Lyons, when he was in committee. When the bill was in committee, put it best. I think he said, we all come here supporting public education as a first priority. But this has been how many years? The same schools over and over again. So I just don't see it the same way. And I look at it as if it was my kid. No way. No way would they put it in school.
So why can't you make these improvements now and then come back in the fall session and then work towards the comprehensive reforms at the same time? Why can't these go hand in hand?
Well, I think there's a lot of different entities involved in the education process. You know, you heard Representative Davis read off the list of the opponents. Mm-hmm. Teachers unions, the principals, the school management alliance. These are all people that run the current system. They have a vested interest in keeping the same system going. They have no they have no reason to make a significant change and to try to give kids another opportunity. And you know, it's job protection for the leadership, and that's a shame. It's a real shame.
What does this letdown mean for the students?
That's who I feel bad for. That's why I'm down to the ground zero. I've lost bills before. You know, that's just part of life, and that's not a big deal. But these kids had a great opportunity with some really strong leadership. I mean, when is the last time you saw a bill that was supported by both leaders of both caucuses that in this chamber, along with Senator Meeks, who has, you know, his own constituency that is bigger than just his senatorial district? When's the last time you saw that fail? And today, you know, those kids lost out because the people that are part of the system are afraid of one little change, giving kids an opportunity to go to a better school.
None of the failing schools are in your district.
No, they're not. Not one single one. And none of the private schools in my district would benefit by these either. And, you know, the whole idea of busing and all that, there's plenty of capacity at all the surrounding schools. You know, that's, they want to put that thing out there and say all these, these falsities. It's just not true. There's plenty of capacity. There's plenty of opportunity for these kids to get a good education if they're given a choice. And unfortunately, we failed to do that today.
Thanks, Representative. Yeah.